With me. What's going on, y'all? Peace and blessings. This is your boy Gerald. It is the 25th of October. How are you? Man, look at my pendant. I got it. See what happens? Flip flopping on the couch. Yeah, there you go. Rightfully where it should be. I hope everybody's doing well. Bear with me. Can you see me now? Yes, you can. You realize how many people think that thought when they come home? It's incredible, ain't it? Still alive. I love this part right here. Love me some Luther. Miss Luther. He went far, far before his time. Did have the pleasure, though, to actually see him in concert. When he did the Superstar Tour, I think I was 19, 20 years old at that time. But I actually got to see him perform at the Capitol Center up in Maryland when I lived in D.C. before I went into the service. And I'm so grateful that I actually had the opportunity to see that concert. Forever missed. Man. But as I was saying, you realize how many people have that thought when they come home, and may it be to someone or even by themselves, they just want their home to be how they envision it in their minds. You know, it's incredible. Because that's where peace should always be found. Should be validated. Because that's who you are. And if you can't find peace in where you lay your head, then that's a place where you should not. So how is everyone doing? You doing okay? How was your week? Did you navigate through all the BS? Did you sidestep the negativity? Did you take the opportunity to go within your heart and mind? I highly suggest that you do, to have courage, because there's only one you. And just like there was someone that prayed for me, I'm going to continue to pray for you. So how is everybody? Doing okay? I want to thank each and every one of you for taking the chance to check out on my channel. For you, those who've never been on my channel, I would like to say welcome. And I hope that the words that fall from my mouth, which come from Spirit, and I know Him as my Lord Jesus Christ, but I am humbled enough to know that He is one of many names. I hope that your week is blessed and protected, because you deserve that. It's your life, and it's very, very important that you define your steps. So, I happen to be, can't wait for that album to drop. I think it comes out in December, if I read correct, Mary's album she did in London. Heard it was pretty good. Can't wait. But I'm a Mary J. fan anyway. Since day one, I've always been riding with her. So, Mary, if you see this video, peace and blessings to you. But I happened to read an article, and then I was, you know, I'm always online when I get a chance. And I noticed that, you know, there has been a resurgence within the last 3 to 4 years that people are slowly but surely putting more focus on their health, and which is not a bad thing at all, because I mean, hey, this is how you move around on this planet, is your physical self, but you do know you're a spiritual being first. You know, that's why that this is going to always age. It is set up to live its purpose, and eventually our life and existence comes to an end. But I've noticed that my queens, I've seen this movement go on where there is, how can I say this, and I'm going to try to pick my words very, very respectfully, so please work with me, but it seems like the mindset that's being projected out is, if I can't beat them, I'm going to join them. Or in other words, I want to be just like them. Let me repeat that. If I can't beat them, I'm going to join them. And I'm going to be just like them. Now, the reason why I say this is because the fact that is, there's only one you. And the question I ask you, and this is for you as well, my kids, is why do you want to emulate? Why emulate someone else when you can define who you are? Now, there's a difference between finding inspiration in something that's positive, but a lot of times it does not manifest that way. So what I'm saying to you is this. I see a lot of people that may have come from a place that they were broken. And they got to that point where they found the courage and strength that they thought, that they said, well, you know what, if I change up my exterior, it's going to change my environment. So I'm going to adapt a certain lifestyle. And by doing these principles are going to give me access to what I think I need. I got a problem with that. Because the problem I have is, you can inspire to be like someone, but you have to do the work for yourself. So when I see people out there that have this copycat mentality, it seems like they cheapen themselves. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, you know, yes, imitation is the best flattery. But guess what? No one can do it but you. No one can be you but you. So it's very, very important that you define who you are. So I'll go a little deeper. Because I know some of my females are saying, I don't get it, Jerry. What are you talking about? Okay, I hear you. I feel your energy. I feel it. Here's my point. Far too many times, I'll see a woman, right? And she is in an emotional state there where she is broken, right? And life at that moment has given her a lot of struggle, right? So she'll think in her mind, well, if I change my characteristics about who I am that will supplement what I really need inside me. But all that does is delay the healing process. I'll do one better. Okay. Haven't you noticed that you have a lot of people running to the gym now? Right? They run into the gym and they're doing it for two reasons. Number one, they're doing it because they're looking at it from a superficial point of view. So they're going to the gym to date, to socialize. Now, before you bite my head off, I'm going to say this. There is nothing wrong with changing your environment as long as there's a positive out of it, right? But I've seen a trend where, and I'm going to be really, really strategic on how I tell this story. I knew this woman back in my military days, right? And, you know, being in the Air Force, we kind of had a lax PT program back then. Now, it's totally changed now because the standards have changed. It's either you're going to turn around, stay in a grade of weight standards and health, or they're going to put you out. That's what it is now because they want a quality. They want a better quality soldier. But I remember when I first got into my first installation, I was stationed in Germany, Frankfurt. And before I came into the service, I was already in the gym. I used to be really big, you know, 245. I was ripped up. And but I was very, very shy. I was very, very, I don't want to say I had an introverted personality. It was just like, nah. If I don't know you, I just keep to myself. And that's just that DC mentality. You know what I'm saying? If I don't know you, I don't know you. But, you know, time will tell. You know, you got to warm up soon. So, I watched, used to watch her come into the gym all the time. I'm in there working out. You know, I'll be in there about an hour and a half, 2 hours. And I noticed at first, come in there and get on the bike, ride that bike for a little bit, and then she get on that elliptical. But needless to say, she was trying to get closer to me. And you know, being a slowpoke Rodriguez, I didn't see that, because the fact of the matter is, I was there for myself. You know, like a lot of people that truly work out, the best time to talk to somebody is within the first 15 minutes of them entering the gym, because a true person that is about working out, they're going to go into this mindset where they're going to block everything out, and they're on this path within their regimen, and then until it's completed, really you're wasting your time. They've got tunnel vision. So, make a long story short, you know, we used to do a little idle chit-chat and stuff like that. And we'd build a rapport. We had built a rapport through time. And, you know, I watched this woman slowly but surely watch her body transform. And that was like, that's right, you're doing the damn thing. Get it. And, but then I noticed with the gains that she was making, it was feeding her self-esteem, but it was also corrupting her ego. So in other words, you know, after periods of time, you know, she was able to fit into the attire that she wanted to wear. And she was really coming into her own. And we used to always have conversations on the treadmill as we ran. And she was telling me about her past and, you know, the adversities that she had to go through. And, And, you know, basically, what was the reason why you decided to go into the military to begin? And I remembered that, like a lot of military, they won't admit it, but a lot of them go into the military because of the fact that they're at a place where either A, they want to go to school, but they don't have the means to do it on their own. So you go to Uncle Sam, and at least for 4 years, he will turn around and give you the right to pursue your educational goals. Some people would also look at the military as a means to walk away from the environment that they were in. It's an out. So they'll look at the military as a way to either enhance their life or change it. And there's nothing wrong with that. Now, to get back to the woman. So she got into her regiment, she got into her rhythm, and she really started seeing the results in it. And then she started, you know, we used to go to the base club all the time, you know, where the barracks was. It was a base club, and everybody would go on Thursday nights. And that was our R&B night. And I noticed that, you know, even when I went to the club, you know, back then, you know, everybody knew me as G Money. And, you know, everybody can tell you, whenever you saw me, I was one of few words, but one thing for sure is I always walked in there, I had my hoodie on, I used to have my baggies, you know, I used to, this stuff that these kids are wearing now, I did 25 years ago. And, but I was very efficient on what I did, because I would always, you know, I was drinking German beer for two reasons. One, I liked the taste after a while, but it was good for weight gain because of the hops and the yeast. But I was very impatient, so what I would always do is when I would come into the club, once I waited in line, I would always get two beers at that time, and I would have them like this. And I'd walk around the club and find me a place to post up, and I would just watch people. Because you would actually see some funny stuff in the mannerisms and the behaviors of what people do. You can do that now. You know what I'm talking about. Best thing, if you want to see something really fun, go to the club, if that's where you are in your life, and don't drink anything for the first hour and a half. Don't do it. And just watch. You will see some hysterical stuff and what people will do just for attention. You'll be surprised. So anyway, to get back to the person. So we fast forward 6 months, and you know, she's dropped 35, almost 40 pounds, and she's, you know, you see her physique, her curves, and you know, first of all, she was very attractive anyway, you know, before the transformation, you know. But then when she changed and came into her season, that brought her the attention that she didn't have. Because the fact that when she started coming to her physical season, she found a confidence in her. She found a position where, you know, fear didn't matter. And actually, what I was witnessing is I saw an arrogance come from it. And that made me scratch my head, because the person that I had met initially and the person she had become were two different people. And it was amazing, because of the caliber of men that were vying for her attention were the same men, type of men that, you know, from past conversations we would have, that she would have nothing to do with. But now she gone home with him now. You know, she, you know, and you know, I kind of would look and I'm like, why are you selling yourself short? You know. And after a while, you know, the person that I knew was totally not the person she had become. So here's my point. My queens, if you're going through some struggles, right? and you're looking at, well, maybe this is the time that I get in shape, or maybe I try something different. Just know this. The person that you are inside will always remain, no matter who you are on the outside, who you project yourself, because usually the person that you project yourself out to be is an illusion. That is why you see so many women that, and men, don't get me wrong, I'm not beating you up, I'm stating a fact, that are so gregarious and they're so animated. They gotta be in the spotlight. Let me tell you what, those same people are the same people that are the most broken and shallowest people you won't ever run into, because number one, they don't know who they are. And you should never, ever compromise who you are. Because you are the same person that you are when you go to sleep, as well as the same person that you see yourself as when you wake up in the morning to brush those pearly whites. If you want to change and have a different life, if you're tired of going through the struggles of life, I'm going to keep telling you this. You got to have the courage to look within yourself, within that heart of yours, and start looking at those wounds. You got to fix those first. It does not matter what you do here. It doesn't matter if you have all the money in the world. A broken person is a broken person. And guess what? Access, financially, socially, or even physically, has no merit unless that is validated, unless that is balanced. That is why, if you look at a lot of these people that have chosen to become celebrities, are the most insecure people on the planet. Do you realize how many people would wish in that status that they could just get in their car and just go to Walmart at 2:30 in the morning if they chose, or go to the 7-Eleven where they're from? They can't, because that's the trade-off. The trade-off was, we're going to put a price on your privacy. So since you don't have it anymore, we're going to give you XYZ amounts of dollars to compensate that. But not amount of money in the world will take away the pain or the fear that's in your heart. That's why so many people think that, well, you know what? Instead of dealing with whatever challenges I got, I'll change the environment and it'll go away. It don't go away. All it does is compound until you decide to deal with it. And then depending on how deep of the depression is, it impacts your health. Everything coincides. So let's go back with the money aspect. Don't you realize the better state of mind that you have, everything tends to work out for you? So it's very important. And see, let me break it down. If your mind is not at peace, your body will not be at peace. There's no such thing as a magic pill to make it go away. You know, these prescription pills are only good for one thing, and that is masking the problem or keeping you in a blurred state. But it's still there until you have the courage to deal with whatever you have to deal with. I know somebody's saying, well, Gerald, well, I got this and I got that, and you know, what am I going to do about that? Doctor said I got this for the rest of my days. I'm going to tell you what. I'll ask you this. Think about the day before you found out. What was your mind state then? And once you identify what that mind state is, does that mind state still exist now? And I guarantee you, you'll see a correlation in that. You know I'm telling the truth. See, remember, for those who didn't see, I put a video out, the one before, maybe the one before that, and I said, in the age group of 30 to 50, this generation is more susceptible to be shackled to prescription pills. The reason for that is there's no money in cures. There's money in sustainment. So if I can give you something just to pacify you for the moment, two things gonna happen. You're gonna make me money, and you're gonna keep coming back. Therefore, you ain't living your life because you ain't at peace. So, what I'm saying, my queens and kings, is this. If you're in a position where you think that making drastic changes are going to be the end-all be-all for what you feel inside, I'm here to tell you, all that does is bring more of that same drama in your life. For my queens, I'm gonna tell you something. Some of you have adapted this ideology where you think that, well, you know what? As I said, if I can't beat them, I join them because it seems like they're having more fun. They're the ones that are getting the most attention. But what you don't realize is if you had the ability to look behind closed doors for these people that you look like, you look at and idolize, I guarantee you would not like what you see. Because there is a trade-off on that. There is a sacrifice that has to be made. And 9 times out of 10, it is from your physical realm. So the question should be asked is this. If your merits of trying to basically create a better life comes by way of you compromising what you know as your life, you've got to be honest with yourself and is it worth it? Because you're priceless. You're priceless, man. You know that, right? And I think some of you right now get what I'm trying to say. Some of you guys are willfully putting a price on your life and saying, well, you know what, Gerald, where my life was before, if I didn't opt to go this right, I wouldn't have what I have. But deep down inside, why do you feel the way you feel? That's why I keep trying to tell you, retail therapy don't work. Being a side chick don't work. Going out there and cheating will never work. Or worse, being the kept woman or man will not work. Because all that does is say your life don't matter. You're just a procurement. You have no value than an asset. Your life is priceless. Stop selling yourself short. If there's somewhere that you wish to be in your life, do the work. Now let's go back to what I was trying to use as an example of the girl. So, you know, my first term and my first installation, I was there for almost 5 years. And, you know, after a while, you know, the young lady and I, we stopped talking. Wasn't personal on my end, it's because of the fact that I didn't like the fact that every week you were going home with a different dude. But yet, you were the same one that I would see crying, shook, abused, mistreated. And I was thinking, I was like, dang, I remember when you first walked into my life. And the little girl that was in you, how just wanted real talk, and who you've become. And I was like, you know what? Now, one thing I will say this: your destiny has already been written when you took your first breath. Trust and believe. So the lessons that you go through, they've already been prescribed. You're going to go through them. But the kicker is, when you decide to embrace them, the moment you decide to embrace your experiences is when you can make the decision to change them. because the lessons that you had to go through will stop when you've mastered that. So, in other words, to my queens and kings, if you're in a season where it seems like you can get them, but you can't keep them because you're not keeping yourself. That's what the law of attraction is all about. You want real love? You gotta love yourself for real. So you gotta make a decision to find a place within yourself to have the courage to start building on. You gotta start taking ownership for your choices and your actions. Because if you don't, let me tell you what's gonna happen. You're gonna have that emotional backpack, and all that's gonna do is make you bitter. It's gonna mess your health up, and you'll end up being alone. See, I saw a correlation that blew my mind a couple of years ago, and I didn't understand what I was seeing, but I do now. Do you realize that you can look at somebody, and you know, they say, "Well, he looks this way, he looks like that," and you wonder how he got that way. You know, it's because of repetition. So let's look at it from an exercise standpoint. So if I'm in the gym and I'm working out and I'm working my biceps, right? And all I do is work my biceps all the time. Well, through time and regimen, my bicep is going to reflect from that behavior because it's routine. So, because we're made of muscle, tissue, and fiber, if I'm constantly putting a regimen on my legs, shouldn't my legs reflect that regimen? Now, let's throw our sexuality in the equation. So, if you, my queens, you have a certain regimen, why do you not think that your body's not going to adapt to it? Think about it. You know what I'm talking about. It's gonna reflect to the regimen. So that's how most guys know. We can look at you and tell what you do and what you don't do. From your jaw structure, we know when you're doing what you do. To your contour of your frame, we know what you do and what you don't. So what I know you said, well, what's that got to do with anything, Gerald? The moment you decide to value the little things, the big things will also have its place. So in other words, what I'm trying to get you to understand is this. The moment you decide to define what makes you, you, guess what? Everything will have merit and fall in place. See, some of y'all don't even realize that the friends that you align yourself with are really your greatest enemies. And you don't even know it because of the fact that you've allowed your shallowness to deceive the way you think. And you think that these people have your best interests. And you don't even realize they're just waiting to stab you in the back. They see you as a resource, or what we know as a come-up, and they're going to play their position until they can't. Think of it this way. If I was to allow Tyson to go out in the woods every day, and, you know, I didn't bathe him, and every day he came in, you know, eventually he's going to have some fleas and ticks on him. Well, the same thing goes with we as people. If you're constantly going out there in environments that you know that you're not supposed to be in, what makes you think that you're not going to bring something back? That's why STDs exist. Because you're doing things you know you ain't supposed to be doing. And do you realize STDs 9 times out of 10 are manifested because it comes from a place of imbalance emotionally? You say, how's that, Gerald? Because when you turn around and compromise your self-worth, you do things through impulse or emotional triggers to put yourself in a vulnerable state. So therefore, say for example, you're going out and you meet somebody and you don't know nothing about them, but you automatically open your legs and then bam, you shook how you got it because you compromised yourself. You didn't see your worth to invest in time. Don't you realize time is the greatest revealer than anything? But you have to be patient enough to invest in the process. So my question to you is this. As I always say, your life is like a harvest out there within that field. You want the flowers and everything that comes with your life to bloom in season. Well, guess what? You got to go out there and survey what is yours, which is your life. You've got to dig up the rocks and debris that is, you know, more or less your experience. And then you have to smooth out the things that are found within you, which is your problems, before you can even plant that right, that first seed, which is your thought, your insight, your goals, your dreams. Now granted, it will still grow. It may take longer. But then don't you want it to be healthy? Sometimes, do you realize sometimes even when it comes to your dreams and aspirations, you may have put it in thought and totally forgot about it. And then all of a sudden you see a offshoot of inspiration or something that you did a long time ago and go, wow, if I'd only know, because it was divinely meant for it to reveal itself when it should. And actually, when you think about it, you were really being protected. So, my queens, not to talk too much. I want you to know something. Stop looking at the things for inspiration that will have negative outcomes. It's very important that you protect your life. And it's very important that you govern who you allow access to your life. If they're not willing to invest in you, in the littlest sense as, hey, are you going to be my friend or are you going to be my lover? Well, why would you want someone to be your lover if they can't be your friend first? You know, that's why that's an issue that, you know, and I'm speaking on this because I too made those mistakes. I went through that season, it seemed like the people that I were attracted to, I was their lover first before their friend. And then the problems came because I didn't know them. And how could I know them if I didn't know myself? So therefore, I was already compromising myself from the jump because I allowed the problems that I would have to face in without any restraint. Now, kings and queens, it's time for you to take accountability for your life. No one can do that but you. Don't you think you deserve to be happy? Come on now. Stop listening to the people in the cheap seats. Stop listening to the people that think they have influence in your life. Because I'm going to tell you what, if the advice they're giving you does not emulate what they're doing in their life, guess what? They might as well be blowing smoke up your ass. Because guess what? Those same people want you to do the work so they can benefit. And whatever it may be, and once they get it, they're going to leave. And that's going to leave you in a cycle repeats itself again. Now you're bitter and resentful because you're like, well, I didn't see this coming. You didn't see that coming because of the fact that you didn't put your boundary in perspective. There are some people, y'all, that they may look a certain way, sound a certain way, act a certain way, only to bring you the greatest pain. That's what that devil does. He lies in wait to kill, steal, and destroy your life. So you gotta make a decision. You gonna be happy? You gonna start doing the work? or you're going to be just like them. Can't beat them. I can't. I might as well join them. And guess what? All those people are miserable. All those people get up and do the same thing all over again. Why? And they're going to continue to be in that cycle until they decide to see their value and worth. Let me throw this out here too, my queens, for y'all that may think, well, you know what, when is Mr. Right going to come? Mr. Right cannot and will not come until you are Mrs. Right. You hear what I'm saying? You want a good man? You have to have the traits to be a good woman. There's no compromising that. And rightfully so. Would you want somebody that can't make you happy, only in one aspect? Well, he's a good lover, but he's responsible in his life. Hello? Why? Why? He's good in his life, but he's controlling. Why? He's self-centered and arrogant, but I can change him. Why? Why do you want somebody that you feel that you gotta change? Number one, that's ego. That's your ego and pride trying to convince you to try to put a square in a circle. That ain't gonna work. That's a waste of time. The people that truly deserve the right to be in your life, you will know that because you will feel it in your heart. It'll feel like breathing. There won't be any drama. Because they respect you, they treasure and they honor you, and they want to grow with you, but they want to be a part of your growth. So it should never feel like you're pulling teeth. And trust and honor should be number one. That is why I'm going to keep telling you this. If you do not have a relationship with your higher power, I suggest that you build it. He's waiting on you. Look, think of it this way. If I told you that I got $1 million check with no name, but there's certain things I need you to do, and you can have it, you would be very, very curious on what it would do. What would you have to do to get that check? Now, take that $1 million check and look at it as it represents your life, the happiness that you dream about, those dreams and aspirations of where you would like to take your life and experience. Well, you can have that the moment that you connect with your higher power. Don't get caught up with, well, how am I supposed to have a relationship with him? It's when you come from a place of your heart. It's no different than you having a conversation with yourself. And you do all the time. When you take away all the BS, all the ego, and be, thank you, my angels, behind closed doors. When you get to that place of saying, you know what? I deserve to have my life as I dream it to be. That's how any inspiration, that's how life is manifested. It first comes from inspirational thought. But who puts that there? Either your higher power does, or the devil does. You got to decide who you're rolling with. But you know what? I believe you can do, Art. I know you can do. Hey, somebody pray for me. I'm praying for you. I'm praying for you. So leave them little girls alone. Cut them little boys up. Cut them out. Now think about it this way. Let's go back to that story with the girl that I was stationed with. So what would end up resulting would be she ended up getting a serious STD. And then on top of that, she was pregnant. And, life got real. Of course she was shook. She was very dejected and she was very angry. But she was more angry with herself because she didn't understand how she could have been so stupid. And I said, first of all, you need to stop beating yourself up. It happened. Own it. What you gonna do about it? Well, we knew that she wasn't gonna, she had already said that she was not gonna have an abortion. And she knew that she would have to deal with the STDs that she got. So she got her treatments for that. And, it kind of scared her straight because you're talking about the effect of a child. You carrying a child and you got multiple STDs now. What do you do? But here's the beautiful thing about what happened. The people that really gave a damn about her was there. We were there. We threw her a little baby shower and stuff. She ended up having a little girl. And she got real serious about her career. And eventually, she would meet somebody very nice. And they would be married. And she later on would get orders and, they went on with their lives. But the point I'm trying to make is, even if you get rocks thrown at you, even if you fall down, even if life deals you cards that you feel are unfair, number one, take accountability of it, because guess what? You had a role and a part in that. Forgive yourself. Never stop loving yourself. And place that first foot forward. But guess what? Guess who's going to be there and was there the whole time? So if you're dealing with depression right now, you're dealing with anger right now, you're dealing with things that have plagued you in your childhood that you don't know how to... Here's the funny thing. 65% of the world populace deal with childhood issues. And those childhood issues impact the way you think as an adult. You're not supposed to go through that. It's time for you to break that cycle. I know some of you are like, well, I was molested, Gerald. I'm a product of incest. I'm a product of adultery. My mom was unfaithful. My dad was unfaithful. And I'm a product of that. And I have shame because of that. I know the truth. Well, guess what? Did you realize it wasn't your fault? So stop claiming that. Stop carrying that burden. Because look, God loved you even more so He made you, He brought you life. So it's up to you to define your life. It's up to you to break that cycle. Break the cycle. Because guess what? You have so many people that love and adore you that are relying that you do. And trust when I say this. You'll see them. You'll see them through your life. You'll see. And a lot of you already know that. So treasure your life. Oh, before I go, because I'm running my mouth too long, I want y'all to look at this episode. Bill Cunningham had yesterday. It was called Deadbeat Moms. That is a prime example of what a generational curse looks like. If you can go on your DVR, pull it up, check it out. And this is something that people don't talk about, but happens all the time. And the common denominator through it all is these women did not love each other, didn't love themselves, but did not have the courage to break the chain. The chain made of pain, resentment, and bitterness. And we have a responsibility, y'all, to be the best we can. But no one's going to do the work but you. So, just know, somebody pray for me. I'm praying for you. If you got any questions and concerns, by all means, you can inbox me or drop a line below. Like, and subscribe. And if you don't like it, you know what? I'd love to get your feedback. And once again, God's praying for you. You know I am. I see your worth. I really do. And for that, it helps me discern mine. Because I'm going to tell you what, society only sees you in one light, and that is serial numbers, dollar signs, a commodity. They don't think that we can think and better our lives. They think we're just going to be sheep and just in the matrix. And that's not the case. You got a job and a responsibility by living and claiming your life first. Okay, y'all, you have a blessed weekend. Stay protected, stay blessed, and of course, stay you. Love to hear from you. Bye-bye, y'all.